Nearly forgot to put my microphone on. Good morning. It's Monday, the 24th of April, 2017. Welcome along very early this morning. It's almost a breakfast show, isn't it? My God, I can't believe I'm here this early. 9 o'clock in the morning and I've started. Wow, that is something. It's getting earlier and earlier. Yes, I got up nice and early this morning, boys and girls. About 7:45, actually. I think that this seems to be happening more often now, getting up early. And I can only, I think it's probably because I now have some nights off during the week by choice. And also the nights that I do work tend to finish 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock is about average now. Whereas years ago, it used to be 3 or 4 in the morning. Oh my God, I'm glad I'm still not doing that anymore. Oh my word. 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. The normal time for me to finish at that time was about 2. I used to think it was 2 in the morning, sometimes 3, sometimes 4, but that's all gone out the window, so I'm very pleased about that. I have been doing little promotional videos. You may have noticed that over the last few weeks. So that is like a little video of a minute long or whatever, telling you that there's a live video coming up. But people seem to be getting confused. And people seem to, I'm sure this is happening, that people think that that is the actual video of the day. Now, if you know me well, you will know that I've got much more to say than within a minute. So I don't know how it's happening, but I think people are getting confused into thinking that that 1 minute promotional video is the video of the day. And come on. You know me very well, don't you, eh? How can I possibly say everything I want to say in a minute? Not possible, lovey. So they are not the actual videos. So I'm going to stop doing those. I'll just put a little note up saying there's a show coming up because people are like watching it and then they're commenting and I think they're getting a little bit upset. Well, probably not upset, but possibly wondering why I'm not replying to them. Well, because that wasn't the video. So this is the video. Is that making sense? You are with us live, incidentally. If it is just gone 9 o'clock on Monday, the 24th of April, you are indeed with us live. A very good morning to you. If it's any other time, you are watching a recording. Who's with us so far? Peter Hyde. Good morning, lovely Peter. When is the last time I saw your little pretty face? Hey, Peter, it's been so long. It's been so long. Morning, Peter. Wayne Martin's with us this morning. Good morning, Wayne. I didn't think you got up at this time. That has surprised me. Weren't you doing a karaoke night somewhere last night? Oh, I've got a story about work in a minute, Wayne. Don't go too far from your receiver. Yes. Emma Louise Bailey is with us this morning. Good morning, lovely Emma. Dennis Granger is there. Good morning, Dennis. Have you moved back up here yet, Dennis? I can't remember. I think you said you were moving back up to London at some point, were you? Can't remember where you are. Do let us know. All right, morning, Dennis. Who else is with us this morning? And John Lowder. Good morning, John. Now, where are you? Are you in foreign places? Are you in foreign places? Jimmy Butler, international, was with us this morning. That is my nephew, Jimmy Butler, who fixed my car. Please say hello to him. He needs friends. God is desperate for friends. Why aren't you at work? 9:05 and you haven't got to your garage yet? That's outrageous. Come on. Chop, chop. You should be getting up at 7:30 in the morning to be there for 8:30 because you never know who might you might get drive-in work. Yeah, but obviously not drive right into the place, but you might get people driving to your front door and saying, hello, you know, people that have had small accidents over the weekend. Incidentally, do you do paint chips? Do you do paint chips? Are they quite easy to do? I know there's a little man around here, I think, who goes around in a car doing paint chips. You ring him up and he comes with his little pot of paint. And it's fixed. I'm no good at anything like that. DIY, don't ask me. Once, Jim, I don't know if you know this, once I've got one of those portable air conditioning things like your mum's got. You know the ones you buy from B&Q and you can wheel them around from room to room and it's got like a big exhaust pipe on it. The same size as the pipe on a tumble dryer, you know. And you can put that out the window if you want, but not very efficient to do that. And block up the gaps, a bit difficult. Or you can put a hole in the wall. And I decided to put a hole in the wall. Yes! I looked on YouTube, just like your dad does, Jimmy. I looked on YouTube, and there was a bloke putting a hole in a wall. And what he did, he got this pipe and drew around it with a felt pen. So I did the same. I thought, right, I love the hole there, and I drew this out. And then I got a drill and drilled lots of little holes around the big hole. Right? And then, with a hammer and screwdriver, because I didn't have a chisel, I then started banging away at the wall. Bang, 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 bang. And I made what I thought was the hole. But when I looked through, there was a brick as well. There was bricks as well. It was like two walls in one. Very, very confusing. Anyway, so I got the drill out and did the other hole with great difficulty. I think I must have destroyed about 10 drill bits doing these holes. And then out come the screwdriver and the hammer again. Bang, bang, bang. Destroyed a couple of screwdrivers as well at it. And then there was my hole. And I was very pleased with myself. Then I put the pipe through and I realised that the hole was far too big for the pipe. I've made the hole too big. So then I had to get a builder in to fix that. Chris Reardon doesn't do DIY. If I was to try and fix a little bit of scratch on a car or something, you know those little pots of paint they get from car dealers? If I was to try and fix it, it would go everywhere. I'm not joking. People would walk past the car while I'm stuck in traffic. Oh, look at that. He's not very good at that. They'd do a bit like that, wouldn't they? They absolutely would. So no DIY, please, here, boys and girls. Please, we can't be doing with DIY here. Good morning to AD James. AD's with us as well this morning. Can someone click a like there for us, please? Because once you've clicked a like, the messages come up. I don't know why, but the messages don't seem to come up automatically until someone clicks a like. So if just one person can click a like, I appreciate that. And thank you, those of you that are sharing the thing on your wall as well. Good morning to Jerry Green. Wayne, he says, please hurry up with your work story. I need to have a bath and know you're not coming with me. You can take your little laptop. Thank you very much, AD. Appreciate that. I can get those now. Lovely. I can do that now. That's brilliant. They're coming up now nicely. Thank you very much. Wayne, can you not take... you're having a bath. What, this time in the morning? Do you have a bath in the morning? Now, usually I go and have a shower at the... Well, I go swimming and I have a shower afterwards, and that's my shower today. It stops my water meter going around here. Have you seen the water bill here? Apparently, and I don't know how it happened, that the water people now send you out a little graph in this area. And it tells you how much water you've used in comparison with your neighbours. And according to this graph, I'm using more than anyone around here in the whole of London. I don't know how that is. I check the meter, I turn the water off, and sure enough, the meter stopped. I don't know how I'm using more water than everyone else. That can't be right, surely. I don't believe it. Anyway, Wayne, why can't you take your little laptop or mobile phone into the bath with you? You can have me just perched on the side of your toilet. Couldn't you? That'd be nice. My work story coming up in a moment. Don't worry, Wayne. Peter's a plumber and a builder here at any time. Oh, right. OK, Peter, that's very useful to know. A builder. I might have you do a small extension on the side of my house. I don't think you need planning permission now for that, do you? I did have once a quote, right, for a conservatory round the side of my house. So I'm like end of terrace. And then... next to me is like a wooden lean-to thing, which is coming to the end of its life. You know, it really is. It's getting a bit rotten. Don't matter how much I paint it, another bit falls off. And there are drips coming through. And I considered once, this is a number of, actually quite a few years ago now, I thought I could have a conservatory on that side. Now, the thing is, the sun doesn't come on that side. Yeah, the sun comes this way. So that you know, it's a bit pointless having a conservatory. But I thought I'd get a quote. And it was like £20,000. How much? Yes, £20,000. Who's got that? Who's got short change? And we can do easy terms. No, I don't want easy terms. Then you'll charge me another 10 grand in interest, won't you? No, you must save up for these things. My dad told me to save up for things, not to get things on tick. Only a couple of things you should get on tick. Houses and cars. That's it. No loans for anything else. No loans for Christmas. Oh, but they really want these toys. Well, you have to tell them you haven't got the money. Don't be so stupid. You mustn't take out loans for toys and Christmas and birthdays and holidays. No. Save up for what you want. Then you won't get into trouble, will you? John is... good morning to Adam the plumber. Morning, Adam the plumber, who called in last night. Wayne, I must tell you... Bye-bye, AD. See you soon. Wayne, on Saturday, I turned up for work and someone else was there. Someone has made an error. Error. No, it hasn't stuck. That was another error. Someone's made an error, and I'm sure it's not me. So I spent an hour and a half driving to work on Saturday. Got there, someone else was there, and I'm like, what are you doing here? Oh, well, it's my week. And I said, oh, God, well, someone's made a mess. Anyway, I didn't stay too long. I said, all right, it's all right, I'll go home. I couldn't be bothered, really. Well, I could be bothered, but it happened. This has happened in the same place before, and I was there first, and he went, so that's okay. Nothing to do with the DJ, but someone's got something wrong somewhere, and I'm sure it's not me. Rarely make a mistake. So I drive an hour and a half to work. Someone else was there. So it's all right, I'll go home. So I then drive an hour and a half home. So I left my house about 8 o'clock and I got back at 11. What a blooming waste of a Saturday night that was. You know, I could have been out partying everywhere, raving with my hands in the air at that wonderful little club in London called Chariots that I haven't been for so long now. Party, party, party. I could have been waving my hands in the air, raving, boys and girls, to NRG, He Never Lost His Hardcore. Anyone know that song? Look it up on YouTube at some time. He Never Lost His Hardcore by NRG. Excellent song. No, not really. But I would have done something else rather than spent an entire night driving around for no purpose at all. Oh, well, so that's my work story. Yes, I think it was. I think it was an error in her thing. It's not the first time, actually. Not that, but other things. Dear me. Thank you, Wayne. Anyway, go and have your bath now because you smell. Pfft, I can smell you from here. Wait. Will people please have baths and showers? And in particular, do you mind brushing your teeth before you start watching and listening to my shows? If you don't mind, please. Thank you very much. I can smell your breath from here. There's nothing worse than smelling someone's breath who hasn't brushed their teeth or flossed. I hope you floss as well. I find there's only one floss I can use, actually, Wayne. The Oral B. You know the ones, it's like a round thing like that. The tape, they do a floss tape. I can't get it in between my teeth. They're so tight. I'm so tight. I really am very, very tight. And I can't... And you go... And it snaps. Oh, isn't that worst thing ever? Floss snapping between your teeth. How does that even happen? This stuff is supposed to be very strong, isn't it? Oh, well. Good morning to Gustav, who says, I had a quick hose wash in the kitchen sink, so well sorted. Oh, Gustav, you're not still washing in your sink. Oh, my mum used to wash me in the sink. We used to have a bath in the sink. Literally. I remember this. She used to pick up first me and then my sister, or the other way around, doesn't matter. And we would have a bath in the sink. Did you ever do that, anyone? I wonder why that is. Is there a reason we didn't use the bath? I suppose it didn't use so much water. Mind you, in those days, no one had a water meter, did they? We were all on water rates. Oh, yes. Pay £200 a year. Use as much as you want. Not now. Got a meter now. Got to be careful. Every drop is counted by those people at Thames Water or South East Water, whoever looks after this, Gustav. Yes, washing in the sink with a bar of soap. I remember that so well. I really do. I don't think I'd even get a toe in my sink now. I'm so fat. just get fatter and fatter. I tried a shirt on just before I came in today. This, incidentally, is a present from my friend Ron, who's recently been to New York. He'd just come back from New York a couple of weeks ago, and he bought me this shirt, and it just about fits. But my medium Yves Saint Laurent blue shirt, which is about 20 years old, one of my favourites, just can't get it done up. It goes over, it's round my stomach. I can't get it done up round my stomach. And I said that to Ron last night. He rung me while he was out, and I said, I can't believe I can't get this on. I said, it's my stomach. It'll go over my arms and over my chest. It won't do up round my stomach. And he always says the same. It's your age. It's your age. It's not fair, is it? Why do stomachs get so big? I don't understand it. Good morning to Nathan Vaporboy Edwards. Morning, Chris. You have too much energy this early. Come on, Nathan. Don't tell me you've just peeled open the eyes, have you? Were you pulling that crusty old sleep off your eyelids? I'm very, very rarely up this time, but I think more early shows. They need to get earlier. We need to be here at 6 o'clock in the morning to take on Good Morning Britain. That's what we need to do. We won't win the BBC's breakfast time because that's very good. BBC, ITV, what's it called? Good Morning Britain. And that old cow Lorraine's on there. Oh, while I was having breakfast this morning, I just flicked on. I was watching the BBC breakfast, flicking between the two while I'm having breakfast. And I flicked over to the ITV one. And there's that, what's her name? Suzanne someone or other. And there's that Piers Morgan in the middle. Smarmy old bastard that, isn't he, eh? Oh, I'm not keen on him. And some other woman on the end. What happened to Ben Shepherd? Has he gone now? Did he get the sack? Or did he walk? Because he used to be on there as well, didn't he? Anyway, and then Lorraine came on. Happy, 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 happy. Oh, hello, how are you today? And that smile, dear. Go away, Lorraine, dear. Go away. And I flicked over. But what a load of old rubbish on the telly. It's all American reruns. Wills and Grace, there was Ironside. I used to like Ironside, you know, the detective in the wheelchair. Fantastic. I like those old 60s, 50s, 70s. I like those old 70s police series. Ironside, Columbo, Kojak was my favourite. Da 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 da. Loved it, Kojak. BBC One on Saturday night. And Starsky and Hutch. You remember all those excellent programmes? Yes, you do. Let me see here. Okay, some stories coming up for you this morning. Don't forget there will be an item of fake news, boys and girls. If you're with us for the whole show, you'll hear an item of fake news. We've got a Facebook profile update that I've spotted this morning. That's quite amusing. So all those are coming up today. First of all, though, are you ready? Speeding fines are about to increase. OK, now this is all over the papers this morning, actually. First of all, over the weekend, it was in the Daily Mail. New powers to crack down on speeding drivers come into force this week, like today. Today, millions of motorists are unaware of spiralling penalties. Under the new rules, drivers caught for the most serious cases of speeding could be fined 1.5 times their weekly take-home pay. Wow. Well, that won't be much if you work in Sports Direct, will it? Eh? So what if you're on a 0 hours contract and you had 0 hours that week that you got caught with a speeding fine? Does that mean it's 0 times 1.5, which is 0? Is that how that works? In the Sun this morning, it says speeding fines are changing. No, hang on a minute. It's the Daily Express this morning. Oh, my God, we've gone up market. The Daily, Nigel Farage's favourite newspaper, the Daily Express. It says speeding fines are changing in the UK today, which could see motorists having to fork out more cash if they are caught exceeding the stated speed limit. Under the new rules, drivers can be charged up to, now this is different, it says 175% of their weekly wage. Now, for those thickos are there who can't work that out, that means if you earned £100 last week and you got caught speeding, you could get fined £175. All right, like to spell it out for you, for those of you that are not good with the mathematics, dear. Mathematics. Yes. Rules can be charged up to 175% of their weekly wage for a major offence. A major offence. Well, you want to see them on the M4 sometimes when I'm coming home. That is a major offence. They are racing. And I'm telling you, when they're racing, I'm in the slow lane. Poor old soul I am, dear. I'm in the on the left-hand. It's not the slow lane, is it? I'm in the left-hand lane. I generally do 55, 60 mile an hour. Policemen overtake me and wave as they go past. That's me. Now, what have we got a rush for? 2 o'clock in the morning. What difference is it going to make whether I arrive home at 3 or 3:10? No difference whatsoever. And I'm in that lane, 55, 60 mile an hour. There are cars passing me on the fast lane, on the right-hand lane. They must be doing 150 mile an hour. They've got to be. And they are racing. And they're one behind the other. And they'll be like this. You know, if the one in front just touches his brake, there would be serious accident. I'm sure there has been many times before. These are the people they want to catch. Do I ever see a policeman on the motorway? No, extremely rarely. And these static police, these static cameras, they don't work. People know where they are. We know that the serious speeders, not the normal speed people like myself, the serious speed people know exactly where those cameras are. And it's just madness. They don't work. You've got to have a policeman up down there, you know, hiding somewhere behind a little post or something, darling, hiding something, and with one of those gun things. That's the only way you're going to catch them. There's a cap of £1,000 on minor speeding offences, up to £2,500 for major one. So £1,000 for a minor speeding offence. Well, what would that be? I wonder what a minor speeding offence was. It says a 3-band system will determine the severity of an offence and corresponds to different charges. These charges are calculated on the percentage base. Now, a minor offence constitutes, oh, I like that word, constitutes a band A charge. Band A charges are for drivers who exceed the stated speed limit between 1 and 10 mile an hour. So, if a driver travels 31 miles per hour up to 40 miles per hour in a 30 mile an hour zone, they can be charged between 25% and 75% of their weekly income. That's a lot of money though, isn't it? So what's the average wage now? £300 a week? So that would be What did it say again? 25% and 7%. Say it's 50, so 5. So that was 300. You could be charged £150 for that. That's a lot of. They must be desperate for money. Don't you think? If a driver exceeds the speed limit by 11 miles per hour and 20 mile an hour, so if you were doing like, if it was 30 and you went like 41 to 50, you can be charged between 75% and 125% of their weekly wage. I have a feeling here the self-employed people are going to come off quite well. I don't know how they work that out. Major offences, which are for speed breaches of between 22 mile an hour and above, are charged between 125% and 175% of their weekly wage. In addition to the variable fee, motorists could land themselves with a driving offence of this nature. They could also receive penalty points between 3 and 6 points. Band A, 3. Band B, 4 and 6. Band C carries a 6 penalty point. So that's the new speeding thing. And quite honestly, good. No, I'm pleased about that because there are some really bad. Oh Christ! What was that? What on earth was that? Did you hear that or not? Did an earring fall off? That happened to Angela Rippon years ago. Her earring fell off. Do you remember that? On the news. quite honestly, there are some really bad driving on drivers on the. It's at night time. When I'm going home, I see it worst. The other week, I was going up to Central Station. I think it was a Friday. I was coming home from Central Station, and I was going along these a road in King's Cross. I'd taken a back road because there was a lot of traffic trying to join the Euston Road, and I'm coming up to like a road narrowing. You know where they narrow the road so that you have to slow down. And behind me, I saw a car going like this, flashing its lights at me. I thought, well, I'm not getting out your way. I'm bigger than you, mate. You know? And he had to stop. And there was another car behind him doing the same. They're obviously mucking about on the road. Where are the police? Nowhere to be seen. It's all very well having these expensive fines, but what if there's no one to catch them? The static speed cameras are not going to catch these people because they know where they are. Not only that, it gets even... Let's just do a couple of messages while I'm sitting here chatting away like you. Chatting away to your boys and girls. Let me just do... Oh, God, what have I done now? Oh, dear. One moment, please. We're coming back. There we are. Have I got that right now? It's very complicated receiving the messages here because they just don't come up. Oh, you haven't put any there. Sorry. I thought I'd missed a couple of messages there. One second. Let me do that. Like, that's the like one there, isn't it? No, that's just this show. Is it that one there? I think it's that one there. One minute. There we are. Yeah, we're back there. Sorry, I thought you might have put messages there. Now, where's that story? Speed cameras. Look, here's some more on the speed cameras. A brand new speed camera could soon arrive in England. Now, are you ready for this one? Which could spell trouble for UK motorists. Oh, really? Surprise, surprise. Surprise, surprise. The new speed camera was launched by a Belgian company. Oh, well, say no more. Say no more. The bloody Europeans again, innit? Sending their crap across here. Perhaps we'll be out of Europe before they can get this one in. Belgian company Secure Road, and it uses infrared light to catch out motorists. By using infrared lights, the car drivers do not notice if they are indeed captured on camera. It can also be hidden almost anywhere. For example, in an inconspicuous rubbish bin or a car. They can hide it in a blooming rubbish bin now. The speed camera is called NK7, and the Belgian company says it can be used without anyone operating it. I mean, this is just awful, isn't it? It just gets worse and worse, this thing about wanting to catch people all the time. After initial tests, the device was deemed to be a success and could soon be trialled on British roads. This is partly due to the fact it can monitor 6 driving lanes at one time, 3 in either direction. So it just gets better and better, doesn't it? A Secure Road person says one picture is sufficient because it can be cloned and the information for each vehicle stays available. A spokesman called the new toy a nightmare for the speeder, said the device would cost about £41,000 to buy. So no doubt, they'll find the money for that. Oh, absolutely. They will find the money for that, wouldn't they? All these police forces. Oh, we got no money. Ah, new speed camera. Oh, we think we can find 50 grand for a couple of those. You know, 500 grand. Oh, that'll buy us a few cameras. We'll get a few of those, catch a few more people. Yeah, they got the money for that. Haven't got the money for the sit at the desk, though, and answer your calls when you get burgled, have they? So that's even more bad news for the speed cameras. God's sake. More and more cameras all over the place. But as I say, doesn't bother me. Don't bother me at all, boys and girls. Keep driving nice and slowly. That's the secret. Drive nice and slowly. Yes. More news stories. Very disappointed to see this story. Now, one of the favourite programmes I like on the television is Can't Pay, We'll Take It Away. Channel 5. And my two favourite people on there, there's a white bloke in his 60s called Paul Bohill, who actually I'm a friend with, is on on Facebook. And there's also a black bloke on there. I think his name is It might be his son who's called Delroy. Father and son, anyway, it's the old one. I think he's called Delroy. I'm not sure. Yeah, it is Delroy. In the Daily Mirror this morning. I know, Daily Mirror this morning. I'm reading from the Daily Mirror here. Can you believe that? In the Daily Mirror, it says on the subject of the lovely Delroy, and he's a nice man. He's a nice man. He generally is either with his son or some awful fat bloke who's just horrible. Do you know the one I mean? With the glasses. Great big fat thing he is. Horrible man. Disgusting man. Delroy, the black guy, is like, he's the nice one and he's the horrible one. Whether or not they go around like that on purpose, you know, have a nice one and a sort of good and bad, I don't know. Anyway. In the Daily Mirror this morning, a dad, because he's a dad, who achieved fame as bailiff on Channel 5's Can't Pay, Will Take It Away, has been handed a death sentence unless a donor can be found to rescue him from a terminal blood cancer. Delroy, who reached unexpected stardom on the show, has been stricken by an aggressive form of leukemia, which ravages the blood and bones of its sufferers. But the dad of six has been confined to a hospital bed while undergoing chemotherapy. He's 56, so a little bit older than me, desperately needs a bone marrow transplant so he can beat the debilitating disease. However, it's proven difficult to find a matching donor because of his minority background, and he has suffered for months since he first hearing the news of his deadly illness. And that's a shame, because he does actually come across as a nice man. He really does. So hopefully he will find a bone marrow donor. I don't know how that works, really. What do they do to a bone marrow? That's the stuff in the bones, is it? Because bones, some bones, are all bones solid? Or are some bones not solid? Because, I don't, sort of different thing but similar. Dogs like bone marrow, don't they? Do all bones have this stuff inside them? Or are some bones solid? I'm not quite sure. Maybe you can tell me that. I would be interested to know, boys and girls. I'd be interested to know if anyone knows the answer to that. Okay. Good. Here's a lovely Facebook status update this morning from the lovely Alex Burrows. London's most popular bus driver, absolutely without any question in my book. And he says, good morning all. I was about to help my brother and sister-in-law with helping them prepare for the move next week. Apparently his brother and sister are moving. I received a telephone call from my brother, Mr. Burrows Jr. Alex, we do appreciate your help, but you see, we've got a lot of valuable glassware and we do love our furniture. And, well, we want the move to go smoothly, but please, there is no need for your help. Really, Mrs. Burrows Jr. and I will be okay. Me? Oh, just get to the point. You don't want my help because I'm clumsy. My brother? Yes. You were worse than Frank Spencer. Oh, Betty, at times. You mean well, but whatever you touch or carry, you always manage to break. Me? Good luck with the move. Are you clumsy? I'm clumsy. Oh, yes. But then sometimes I think to myself, you know, you're clumsy because of the way other people have their stuff. Now, for example, my mate's house, Ronnie's house, right? He's got things like glass things on like small shelves next to the wall. And you can't help but turn around and knock something over, can you? It's just the way it is. Very, very difficult. Very, very difficult. To not knock something over. Have you been clumsy in the past? What things have you knocked over, boys and girls? That's my question to you. Have you ever been clumsy in the past? Tell me about it. We've got a phone line open now if you want to call in. 0208 144 3477 is my local London number, OK? 0208 144 3477. If you're available to call in. Now Ray says the lipstick is out a bit this morning. Why has it taken so long for someone to tell me that? I could have sorted that out right at the beginning, couldn't I, Ray? Oh, dear me. Gustav says you don't get this with James O'Brien. Is it out now? I can't do anything about that now, Ray. I can't believe people have waited until now to tell me that. Now, shall I carry on or finish now? Dear, dear me. Oh, it's such hard work sometimes. It really is. Let me see if I can see that myself. 1 minute, let me try something. Yeah, isn't it? I can see what you mean now. It's too late for me to do anything about it now, Ray. That's the trouble. Oh, dear. Never mind. Never mind. No, that's thrown me off. Right, I'll go to the birthdays now, and then we're finished today, boys and girls. Okay, happy birthday today to Tim Hadley. Hello, Tim, who is in New York. New York, New York. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Happy birthday, Tim. Happy birthday to Sven, 59 years old today. Are you the Sven that come to the karaoke? I think you might be. Happy birthday, Sven. Andy Kankett is his birthday today. Good morning, Andy. Emma Amelia, happy birthday, lovely Emma. Lovan Anthony, happy birthday, Lovan. Robert Mitchell. Hello, happy birthday, Robert. 30 today. I remember the first time you came into heaven. When I was DJing there. Happy birthday, Robert. Cristobal, Howis Paleds. Happy birthday to you. Did I manage to get your name right, Cristobal? I try my hardest. You know that. I try my hardest. Mark Goldie, it's his birthday day. Happy birthday, Mark. Grant Knowles, DJ. Worked with you in Brighton many years ago, didn't I, Grant? Happy birthday, Grant. And Jose Vega is 44 years old today. Happy birthday to you. Let's Oh! Where's all that gone? Hang on a minute. Where's all my... Everything's disappeared from the screen suddenly. Here we go. Here we go. Happy birthday, everyone. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right, gang. Enjoy your birthday on this Monday. That's it today. I'll finish up now because that threw me completely off, Ray Reynolds. And I can't do anything about it now. Once I know there's something not working right, I'll have to disappear, I'm afraid. I need to disappear. Tonight, it's karaoke tonight. That's at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. The show starts at 8 o'clock and grows right the way through until 11:30. That's cheap drinks as well. Cheap drinks and karaoke tonight at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, 8 till 11:30. Enjoy your Monday. I'm going to go out for a walk now. I can't go swimming now. Swimming pool closed for a whole week, dear. So I'm going to go for a nice walk over in the forest. Have a nice Monday and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching and listening. Bye-bye now. We'll be right back.